Two Philippine-built Cube satellites were recently launched to the International Space Station. Let's talk about that feat with Paul Jason Kuo. He's the project leader of Maya. Good morning, engineer. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning.
All right. First off, tell us about this new milestone marking. It's the second time our country sent CubeSats that were locally developed into space. What's different this time around?
Yeah, so as you mentioned, this is the second time that we have launched satellites that have been developed locally. So the form factor of the two satellites are similar to the previous ones, but the most significant difference, if you ask me, is that we are slowly trying to introduce more locally developed technology into the Cube satellite. So previously, most of the components, or maybe all of the components, were imported. So this time, there are some parts in the new CubeSats that were sourced locally, meaning that it's easily available here in the Philippines rather than having to go through the trouble of importing them here.
Mm-hmm. And what are Cube satellites in the first place? What do they do for us as opposed to, previous satellites?
So Cube satellites are very tiny satellites. They're 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters in size, particularly these Cube satellites that we're going to deploy in maybe a month. So you can actually hold it in the palm of your hand. The primary use, at least for our case, for the Cube satellites, is that we use this as a tool for people to learn how to build satellites. So when you're building small satellites or you're building large satellites, the fundamental concepts, the fundamental knowledge that is required to be able to do so is the same. So by doing these smaller ones, we're preparing more people to be ready to build bigger satellites when that opportunity comes.
Right. So there's an educational aspect to this as well. We'll talk about that later on. But how will Maya 5 and Maya 6 be operated once deployed?
So once the satellites have been released from the International Space Station, we have an amateur radio satellite station located at the Electrical and Electronics Engineering Institute at UP Diliman. And that's where the home base of operations are going to be. But we also have partners from other universities here in the Philippines that have their own satellite station. And we're going to be asking help from them as well to monitor and track our satellites once they are released.
And we've since said that you recognize the hard work that your scholars put in despite challenges during the pandemic and the like. Do you think milestones like these encourage others to take the same path?
Yes, I'd like to think so. If you asked me 10 years ago if the Philippines would be building our own satellites, I would have said no. But now we're here, we're building our own satellites. We're slowly trying to build a local space ecosystem where we're going to be able to build these satellites here in the Philippines. So, and the fact that we've already sent a few of these into space, I find it very inspiring, particularly for the younger generation. Since we're already here now, who knows what we'll be doing in the future?
And let's go back to the educational aspect. You also wish to pave the way, right, for more talented young people to pursue STEM and assure that the space program and engineering will be part of this, of the scholarship program. Are you in coordination with the DepEd for this? And what's Stamina for Space program?
So I'll answer the second question first. So the Stamina for Space program is the successor of the Phil Microsat program, which gave us Iwata 1,
so
Iwata 2,
that's a different thing.
Maya 1 and Maya 2. Now, the major difference between that initial thrust and Stamina for Space is that we want to try to bring, where we basically partnered with our Japanese, other Japanese universities, our partners from Japan. So for the Stamina for Space program, the main idea is to bring all of that knowledge back home. So the stuff that we have learned there, building the satellites, building the payloads for the satellites, essentially the idea was to try to localize it more and to basically spread it more here in the Philippines. So we have five projects under the program. So the optical project, which deals with building of the cameras that will be put on the bigger satellites, the PHL50, which deals with the Diwata bus, the localization of the Diwata bus, my project Step Up, which is more of the education aspect and the development of these cube satellites, the GRASS project, which is more on the processing of the data that we get from these satellites, and finally ASP, which has been taken over by the Philippine Space Agency, which will build a bigger microsatellite in the future.
And let's go back to the other question
Yeah,
about
for
incorporating space science and engineer
yes.
into
So
scholarship programs.
for our case, at least the Step Up project, what we're doing is we're training more, well, professionals, engineers, already engineers. But I know that the Philippine Space Agency is in coordination with DepEd in trying to bring space science and technology and applications down to, at the very least, the senior or junior high school level. So I mentioned before earlier about the amateur radio ground stations that we use to control the satellites. I know that the space agency is planning on building some of these ground stations for high schools, senior high schools, so that in their science classes they can talk to these cube satellites and maybe eventually control these cube satellites. And I know that they are in coordination with the Department of Education.
Now, tell us about the next nano satellite. This is the Maya 7, right? Who will be behind the process of designing and developing this?
So Maya 7 is development of Maya 7 is currently undergoing. So we have seven graduate students at the Electrical and Electronics Engineering Institute who are again building, designing this cube satellite. And this time, this is being the Philippine Space Agency has a more active role in the development of Maya 7. So aside from that, aside from the graduate students, the Maya 7 was also opened up to other universities, other academic institutions where they can propose missions that the satellite can do. So I think that was last year, I think, where maybe six or seven ideas were chosen. And right now they are working closely with our students building, who are designing and building the Maya 7 to make sure that everything would work together.
All right, lastly, before we let you go, how can we fully realize the benefits of space technology? What's essential to equip our researchers and scientists with it?
Of course, government support is very important, and we're very grateful for the continued support that we get from the government. And of course, we want the next generation to be inspired to want to do this. And to do that, we want to also build a local space ecosystem, because even though you have very talented people, we have a lot of talented people. If they have nowhere to go here locally, then most likely you will experience brain drain. So I think that's one of the major thrusts of the Philippine Space Agency, in that we're, aside from just doing the usual things that space agencies do, is that they're trying to build a local space industry so that our local talent will have something to do here in our own country.
All right, all exciting things ahead. Thank you for your time and your insights, Engineer Paul. You stay safe and thank you for all that you and your team do.
Thank you very much.